Theorem of central angle and inscribed angle. The central angle theorem states that the central angle from two chosen points A and B on the circle is always twice the inscribed angle from those two points. For this circle, the center is O. So the central angle from the points A and B is equal to angle AOB. And the inscribed angle from the points A and B is angle ADB when D is the point considered on the circumference of the circle. So according to the hypothesis, we can write that central angle AOB is equal to 2 times the inscribed angle ADB, and it is given that ADB is equal to 55 degrees. That is why AOB is equal to 2 times 55 degrees, which results in 110 degrees. As AOB is equal to 110 degrees with the endpoints A and B, so the arc ACB has a measure of 110 degrees, which is the minor arc created by the endpoints A and B. So the major arc ADB will have a measure of 360 degrees minus 110 degrees, which results in 250 degrees, because we know that an entire circle is considered as an arc of 360 degrees. So the inscribed angle can be defined by any point along the major arc of endpoint A and B. As the central angle is 2 times the inscribed angle, therefore the inscribed angle is half of the central angle. Inscribed angle by the same arc. Angles subtended by same arc at the circumference of circle are equal. For example, the inscribed angle ABC and ADC are on the same arc AEC with the endpoints A and C. So angle ABC equals angle ADC. It is given that angle ABC is equal to 30 degrees, so ADC is equal to 30 degrees as well. And both of the angles are inscribed angle, and they have a measure of 30 degrees. So the central angle from the points A and C is equal to AOC, which will have a measure of 2 times 30 degrees, which is equal to 60 degrees. Because we know that the central angle is 2 times the inscribed angle. Angle inscribed in a semicircle. Angle inscribed in a semicircle has two endpoints, for example A and B, endpoints of a line that goes through the center of the circle. And we know that a line goes through the two points on the circumference of the circle and the center of the circle is the diameter of the circle, and the diameter of the circle divides the circle into two semicircles. As the circle is considered as an arc of 360 degrees, so each of the semicircle is considered as an arc of half of 360 degrees. So the intercepted arc for an angle inscribed in a semicircle is equal to 180 degrees equals 360 degrees divided by 2. For this circle, the central angle considering the endpoints A and B is equal to 180 degrees. And the inscribed angle from the same two points is ACB, where C is a point on the circumference of the circle, which will be a right angle, because we know that the central angle is 2 times the inscribed angle. As the central angle is equal to 180 degrees, so the inscribed angle is equal to half of the central angle. So angle ACB equals half of 180 degrees, which equals 90 degrees. So angle inscribed in a semicircle is always 90 degrees. And if A, B, and C are three distinct points on a circle, and AB is the diameter of the circle, then angle ACB is always the right angle, which is equal to 90 degrees. Angle with vertex inside the circle and their arcs, or angle formed inside the circle by two intersecting chords. For example, for this circle, the intersecting chords are AB and CD, and the intercepted arcs are AYC, which has a measure of 120 degrees with respect to the center, and BZD, which has a measure of 30 degrees with respect to the center of the circle. So the measure of angle with vertex X inside the circle is equal to half times sum of the intercepted arcs. So the measure equals half times the measure of arc AYC equals 120 degrees plus the measure of arc BZD is 30 degrees. So the measure of angle with vertex inside the circle equals half times 150 degrees for this circle, which results in 75 degrees. Angle with vertex outside the circle and their arcs, or angle formed outside the circle by two intersecting chords or secants AB and CD, where the intercepted arcs are AYC and BZD. When AYC has a measure of 30 degrees and BZD has a measure of 150 degrees with respect to the center of the circle. So the measure of angle with vertex X outside the circle equals half of difference of the intercepted arcs. As we get that the measure of arc BZD is 150 degrees and the measure of arc AYC has a measure of 30 degrees, so the measure of angle with vertex outside the circle equals half times 150 degrees minus 30 degrees equals half times 120 degrees, which results in 60 degrees. Thanks for watching. Perceive, persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thanking you from High Study Prep.